Hey folks, welcome back. I'm continuing my Clockwork Empires version 34 playthrough talk over thing. I've started over on a new map. You can see I've played approximately the same level of development, but this is on the jungle biome. Just for, you know, visual variety, no particular reason. I'm hoping to be able to show off some of the new stuff. There's a new building, the laboratory, which houses a new module, the macroscope. And you can use the macroscope to investigate mysterious objects that you find in the field. So I'm also hoping to find, you know, at least one of those. But first, let's deal with these immigrants. What do I need? It'll take three of anyone. Alright, let's get you assigned. My military strength is a little bit lacking. That should be okay. Here we go. So got a chapel under construction. Funny story. When last time I had a call in a favor event from the Empire, and I elected to take three criminals. One of them was this vicar, even though at the time I did not have a chapel built. See the vicar here? Mr. Rooster Wood. So you'll see, he's, as are all criminals, he is brutish and of criminal element, but has also had seminary training, and he is now my former convict vicar. Hopefully that doesn't come back to bite me in the ass. Good soldiers of the Empire defending the honorable colonists. As you can see, I'm in the process of converting this flax field to growing maize, and I've actually got a second maize field here, so we're going to be up to our ears in corn, hopefully. Although, as you can see from my stockpiles, there's been a ton of coconuts, which is cool. My kitchen staff has been busy converting it into stew. Right, so the chapel is built. Next thing I'm going to build will be the new building, the laboratory. Or laboratory, if you're American, I guess. One day I'm going to build a colony entirely out of Tetris shapes. Then I can put those object stacking skills I wasted so much time on to good use. Right, so new module, the macroscope. It's fairly expensive in terms of resources it requires. Right, brass cogs, some copper pieces, and glass. The reason I'm confident I can build it though is because, if you can see here, I got glass in one of my recent random resource drops. Otherwise, I would be a very long way from building a macroscope, because there's no shoreline. Oh, maybe there is. And without a shoreline, there's no sand. And without sand, there's no glass. And to turn sand into glass, you have to build a refinery. And anyway, I managed to skip all those steps because I got glass at random. So lucky me. Now I'd better build some doors into this building. Also, I see we have some events incoming. Fish people. Ah, it's only three. I'm sure we'll be fine. What other modules go in the lab? I'm going to assume the chalkboard's just decorative. But I don't know that. Having never built one before. So I'm just going to build all this stuff. Cool. This workbench accommodates three workers. So what happens when we assign a work crew to the lab is that, like assigning a work crew to the chapel, the first dude becomes the vicar, and then all of his work crew members become congregants. When you assign a crew to the lab, the first guy becomes, I believe, a scientist, and everyone else becomes lab assistants. Here's a soldier without a gun. Actually, I hope I have guns for my military. I've got a bunch of... Yeah, I think I should be okay. If it weren't for my fortunate starting position near a coconut grove, I'd be running out of food. So I was quite fortunate in that regard. Let's watch the progress of the lab. Complicated looking, is that diagram upside down? No, I guess not. Some people are talking about communism. Again, I've taken the step of not bothering to weed out cultism. It hasn't hurt my more recent playthroughs as much as it used to. I don't know if that's because of a deliberate change in the back end somewhere, or... I don't know, just the way... like, colonist AI works now. But I've fallen into the habit of not executing cultists. Just let them do their thing. Oh. The macroscope. Modern of the wonder... wonder of the modern age. And the chemistry workbench. Which, might actually be the same module that appears in the chemist's workshop. Let's see what the lab can do. Apparently nothing. Nonetheless, I'm going to assign a crew here. Let's check out the work crew menu. Mr. Robin. Mrs. Robin's tasteful saws. So as you can see, Leola Robin has become a scientist. These two, if I can find one. He is now a lab assistant. Now, they're not going to have much to do. I have nothing to research. But when I do, the infrastructure will be in place. We are running a little bit short on food. I'm going to do a little bit more foraging here. Oh, good. Supply drop, just in time. I'm actually going to take some food. I love that new animation, the parachute crate. Dropped off some bread, sausages, and whiskey, and what is this? Oh, more whiskey. I'm sure my colonists will be happy about that. So at this point, I think the colony is pretty self-sustaining. Again, relative to previous revisions, I have a lot of colonists. I mean, it's only day 5. In this particular game, and I've got 31 colonists. Because of, somebody just died. There are multiple events that will give you colonists now? What just happened here? No. An overseer wandered too far, and I guess he was stabbed to death by that bandit. Oh, he was really far away. His work crew was abandoned, unfortunately, so let's reassign his workers. Good enough. Here we go. So, one of the changes, most recent changes in this version, is that the day-night cycle has been tweaked a little bit. So the cycle, an entire day now lasts 8 minutes. And the day-night ratio, according to the patch notes, is 3 to 1. So day lasts 3 times as long as night. Which is to say, 6 minutes of day, and then 2 minutes of night, every 8 minutes. What happens at night is that people are far less likely, they place a far lower priority on doing jobs. Like, their tendency to do things is determined by basically the sum total of a number of numerical influences, right? And those numerical influences are determined by things like their traits and their circumstances, and whether or not they're starving, things like that. Their tendency to do jobs decreases when it's nighttime, and they will they will have an increased tendency to do things like go inside and gossip. And appropriately, nighttime is when culty thoughts spread. I could take more criminals. I think I'm not going to. I don't need the extra workers. I actually need more overseers. We can, actually, let's take a look at the new grass graphics. Grass used to only work in two dimensions, which is to say, when we rotated around it, it would be like looking at a sheet of paper from the edge. So the grass model has changed, and now it works even from any perspective. A nice little tweak. Some animal behaviors were tweaked as well. Herbivores, like jungle fowl and giant beetles and things, if you don't manage them, or if you do nothing and they're able to approach a field unattended, they'll actually eat those crops. So eat this corn, they'll eat flax, things like that. Colonists have a new related behavior in that they will shoo animals away from the fields. Which is cool. So now, like in real life, animals will damage your crops. And foxes will, as always, eat whatever meat they have lying around, which includes corpses and buckets of sausages and things in your stockpile. Which is all pretty cool, I think. Where is my explorer? Is he middle class? Ida, you're a naturalist. Here we go. I believe I only have one explorer. Alright, where is Ida? Ida is she's off doing her own thing, exploring. Oh, what is she doing here? Well, she's doing naturalist-y things. She's documenting grass. So there's a chance that she will uncover eldritch artifacts, basically, when she does stuff like that. And when she investigates rocks in the same way, she will sometimes discover that there are like hematite nodes or chalk nodes and things. I imagine what I'll do is I'm going to continue this playthrough on this map until we see some of the cool new stuff. I would really like to see the Fishman transformation. I'd really like to dig up some of those cool new artifacts. Unfortunately, those things are out of my control. They're pretty random. I think, yeah, food is okay. How many beds do I have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7? 7 beds is okay for 30 colonists, right? They can, sure they'll have no problems taking shifts sleeping. I'm kidding, that's actually pretty crappy. Sure they would appreciate more beds? Just jam a bed into the lab here. Oh, I've got a wave of immigrants. Now I need an overseer. And now I'm going to skim off all of my existing crews to populate the new crew. There we go. With the increased immigration via prestige favors and the usual immigration waves, it's much easier to replace colonists who either die to raids or you have to shoot because they're getting all culty. But the key to maintaining an effective larger population is, of course, food production. So you can't just go whole hog and get, you know, several dozen colonists without also ramping up your food production. That said, food, basically food production is now the limiting factor rather than survival. So that's just changed, you know, some of the previous dynamics of the game. Oh, here's a shoreline. When did I uncover this? My goodness. This being the jungle, unless it's a coastal shoreline, what happened to all the water? I don't know if the water is supposed to... the water level is supposed to rise and lower like that, or if that was some sort of weird graphical glitch. Oh, that's pretty cool, actually. I didn't know that was possible. The water level rises and falls. More fish steaks are walking toward my colony. Alright, I'm going to cut this one off here to keep the video short-ish. I think the next thing I'll build in future videos is maybe a brewery, so I can take advantage of this maze and start brewing some chicha as well, so my colonists will have booze. But until then, thanks for watching this one. My name is Alfred, this game is Clockwork Empires, it's revision 34. You can buy it on Steam, it's in early access. And until January 2nd, it's 10% off its usual price. Because the devs felt like doing something festive. So there you go. Alright, have a good one.